Yo, BattleRap.com, Back to Basics 3. I'm here with Disaster. You're wearing the crown for a reason, kiddo, huh? What's the reason? Why are you wearing that crown, man? Why are you sipping on champagne, bro?
It's not, it's sake.
I
picked up this fucking habit from the dumbfounded battle.
So what happened, man? What happened in that battle? Do you feel like you won?
Yeah, I mean, I easily won. I didn't even use all my shit, and I don't know, man. Like, you know, I kind of told Joe Nye to just, you know, come over here. I think he's, like, taking it hard on himself right now, and I kind of told him to, like, not come here expecting to win, to just do his thing. I think it would have been a lot easier. I think he was expecting, like, completely just, like, wipe the floor with me, which is not going to happen. I didn't even structure a single round. I told people that I did because I wanted to show fans that they're hypocrites and they actually love me for being me. They always want to act like, you know, oh, we want you to do this and do that. Well, these rounds, none of them were fucking, you know, the first round was a little bit fucking, you know, structured. But anyway, and I have proof because I spit all my shit to a lot of the battlers before the battle, you know what I'm saying? And it's completely different bars. So I did what I do, man. This is what I do. I've been battling for 15, 16 years. I will destroy you if you try to come into my fucking lane. I have more experience than you. I'm a god at this shit. You don't pick up what I know overnight. That's why I destroyed the dude in Lebanon when I dissed him in Arabic, because he was rapping for the first time and I've been planning.
You feel bad about what you did?
Yeah, I was going on a tangent right now. I don't feel bad because I was going to do him way worse.
But when you just said like he's kind of feeling down on himself, it seemed like you kind of felt bad for him.
Nah, he'll be okay. He's a fucking grown man. It's just, you know, he just bounced right away and he stormed out of here. I wanted to talk to him, you know what I'm saying?
What would you say to him if you could talk to him?
I already told him. I was like, he's like my favorite battle rapper right now.
But you weren't saying that before the battle.
No, I was calling him garbage. The reason why is because I didn't want to fucking, you know, gas his head up. Even the reason why I was telling him like, oh, I'm coming serious, and I was acting like I was mad at him, it was all a fucking front so I could just clown him in the fucking ring. I didn't want him to know I was going to clown him because then he would have predicted that. I wanted him to think it was some serious shit so he could come here with his guard up tripping out and then like realize that I'm just fucking with him. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's kind of the approach. I was. That's the weird shit. You know why? I think the reason why I ended up being more aggressive than I planned is because there was no mics. For real. Like, I didn't plan on being that aggressive. I'm going to be honest.
What do you mean? What do you mean there were no mics?
I was going to be a lot more laid back than I was today. I just ended up.
What do the mics have to do with you?
Because I had to be heard, dickhead. What the fuck?
I'm trying to fucking let you explain it to the people, man. Oh, not everybody understands. Yeah, we're doing fucking interviews. Hey, Jesus Christ, man.
He's a fucking news reporter now. All right. So, yeah. The reason why I'm saying there's no mics, because we weren't using the normal mics we use, so you could speak into them and like people could hear you more clear, you know what I'm saying? So you're yelling and, you know, it wasn't that good a projection. Like, people in the back couldn't really hear a lot of the rappers, so I had to yell. Because Pass, I couldn't hear him. There were certain battlers I couldn't hear from the back, so, you know what I'm saying?
And you think he wasn't ready for that? Like, as far as how he projected.
Well, yeah, this is what he didn't know. Look, what I already knew. It's like his energy is a very simple like signature of my energy,
right?
But it's a little different, but it's very similar. And he uses that around people that are laid back, and he's never had that go against a real dude that's like loud and crazy like that. So whenever because I know why this style works. I'm the only dude in the game that's ever been like this, and I started this style, and that's why I'm known for it, because it works against styles, you know what I'm saying? He uses it when I'm not around, it's just as effective as when I am. So now when I'm in front of him, it's the real, like, you know what I mean?
So tell me about what happened with you two. So it seems like you got a little aggy at Lust during the battle. You kind of like got a little mad at Organic as well.
Fucking Organic just kept jumping. No, they're my fucking homeboys. Like, I fucking love Organic and Lust.
Homeboy? No, it's my fucking. This dude's like a brother to me. First of all,
they're both like my fucking brothers. But listen, what I'm trying.
I would have looked like a dick if I had allowed him. Like, he was already so fucking like. You were already going so fucking bad on him.
Like,
he was spazzed to death. You already fucking have such a huge advantage. If I didn't interject right there, I would have looked like a dick. I knew he was going to push me. He said so before. He's like, if you are Organic, get in between and throw up my momentum, I'm going to fucking push you. I didn't give a fuck. I knew what I was going into. I took the push from the homie. Hella beer spilling everywhere, you feel me?
Right,
didn't even get on my cavales. It don't matter. I love you, dog. No, I just had to say, like, wasn't no thing, but we treat MCs from everywhere equally. It don't matter. You feel me?
Nah, we was feeling Joe Nye too, man.
King does his thing, though.
I wanted to let people know I was feeling Joe Nye. I hope the camera caught me. Like, I was, a lot of his bars, people weren't, give me that shit, fucking asshole. a lot of the bars that people were fucking, you know, like people weren't catching that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I got some shit slept on, but it's okay. He did too. Oh, he did? Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I know. And I did too. But you know what? I actually fucked up my whole intro, the whole clear body. Like, this shit's about to be a jellyfish because this here is a clear body. I fucked up the whole thing. Hold on. I want to respit the scheme. The scheme was, it's just adrenaline. I was like, I'll admit the last couple of years I've been real sloppy. I gave these people a reason to sleep on me. But now I'm on some next level shit. I promise you all a jellyfish, because this here about to be a clear body. And I said real body.
Joe and I knew, because Joe and I picked up on that 2.5 bars in, or like a bar and a half in, and he was about to say clear body, but Diz flipped it on him and said real body. No, it's subconscious, bro. How many things go on in battles that people aren't even aware of? It's the energy that is exchanged is so much more deeper. So that's what happened, all right? He didn't fuck up that bar. He switched it on Jonai at the last minute.
But Diz, man, why do you get like that in the middle? Why do you get like that in the middle of battles where you're like pushing Lush and you're pushing like fucking organic and shit?
Look, man, I just felt a hand on me while I'm trying to perform. Like, who the fuck want that, bro? You try to run up on a dude while he's performing on stage, people get fucking knocked off stage. I don't know who's touching me. I don't give a fuck. I'm just pushing, bro.
Yeah, you knew it was Lush who was touching you.
He said, fuck you, Lush.
Whatever, that shit's gonna look crazy on camera. They better not take it out.
So is that part of it? Is that really part of it? Like, it's gonna look sick on camera? If you're like, get off me, like, I'm going to keep rapping.
Because I probably look like a pit bull in there. Like, everyone's trying to stop me, and I'm throwing them around. So it's
Yeah. What's good next, bro? What's good next?
Oh, yo, we got this Halloween party this week. Oh, damn, they're kicking us out. But, we got this Halloween shit, man. And, you know, I got this guy right here in it, man. Hey, thank you for, you know, we could stay. That's cool. Good looking out, man. You the man, bro. So, yeah, we cool with the guards and all that. So, yeah.
The Halloween party will be tough. So, but who do you want to battle next? Big K or what?
Big K?
Big K
is scary, dude. I ain't trying to battle him.
He's scary as fuck, man. That's what I was trying to tell him, man.
I got to change my format to battle K. I don't want to have to do all that. I have to go bar for bar with his ass.
So he doesn't want it with Big K, he said.
No, because I like rapping for a long time filler.
He said he doesn't want any smoke with Big K. He said he doesn't want any smoke with
Big K. He's a jackass, man. Don't do that. God damn.
No problems with K, man.
Neither does anybody, I'm telling you, man.
I'm trying to keep my new buzz.
Exactly, man.